In this video, I'm going to show you how to solve a 5x5 Rubik's Cube. Check out my other video showing you how to solve a 2x2 Rubik's Cube, a 3x3, a 4x4, and even a 5x5. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to solve this 5x5 Rubik's Cube. For the purpose of this video, you should already know how to solve a 3x3 Rubik's Cube, and preferably a 4x4 Rubik's Cube too, as many of the movements are the same. If you don't already know how to solve a 3x3 and a 4x4 Rubik's Cube, then I suggest you check out my 3x3 and my 4x4 Rubik's Cube tutorials, as all the movements and algorithms from the 3x3 will also be used in this tutorial, and many of the movements and techniques from the 4x4 will too. However, most of the extra algorithms that are used only for the 4x4, we won't need for this 5x5. In fact, I'm going to try and show you how to usually avoid using any of them from the 4x4 altogether. So now that we've mixed our cube, we're ready to start solving this cube. And like a 4x4, with a 5x5, the first step is to start arranging these centres. These 9 centre pieces here represent one centre piece on a standard 3x3 Rubik's Cube. Like with a 4x4, we had 4 to make up in the middle. That was the first step. On the 5x5, the first step is exactly the same. First, we need to make the centres. Now, unlike a 4x4, on the 5x5, we have got actual centre pieces here. The 4x4 wasn't even, so we didn't. And these centre pieces are fixed, so we don't have to worry about the orientation of the centres. Green is already opposite blue, orange opposite red. They're already fixed, so we don't have to worry about what colour goes where. You'll also be pleased to note that there's no algorithm to learn in order to do these centres. There is a technique that you need to use. I'm going to show you the technique that I use, and the order of which faces. And then you just follow that technique and try and figure it out using logic. So the first thing we need to do is choose a colour to start on. As per all my other Rubik's Cube tutorials, I'm going to start with green. So the first step is to find the green centrepiece. There it is. And then to start filling this completely with green, we need to make a line of 3 in the same colour going through the centre. So we need to make a horizontal line in the middle here. So first we need to find one of these edge pieces. I keep calling them centre pieces, but they're kind of edge pieces on a 3x3. So we need to find one of these pieces on the side. I've got one here, but you see how it's on the top? We want to put it on this middle layer here. Either side will do for the moment. And then we can turn it up and we've got our first one. So now we need to look for another one. We've got one here. This one's on the left, so we need the empty space on the left. We can just turn it up, and we've got 1, 2, 3, and we've made a first line of 3. You always want to start making a line of 3 through the middle. Once you've got your first line of 3 through the middle, we start making a line of 3 for either here or here. So again, look on the side. We want to start with a middle piece, so find one of these middle pieces or edge pieces. We've got one here, and it's already got one attached to it. This one is on the right. The bottom right is done. We just need to put one on the top right. So look for one on the side. So we've got one here. It's on the bottom left, but we want one on the top right. So we can just turn this face, place it on the top right, and now we can bring it to this pair and make a line of 3. Once we've got another row of 3, make sure this is now vertical. We can just turn it up and join them together. And do the same again. We want to make another line of 3 on the side. We've already got 2 matched up here. Once again, we just need one in the top right. So find the remaining square. Here it is. It's on the bottom right. Turn it into the top right and bring it around. And now we've made another row of 3. 1, 2, 3. Turn it vertical with the empty space on the same side as your green. Bring it up, and now we've completed our first centrepiece. Now this is equivalent to just one centrepiece on a 3x3. So next step, same as with my 4x4, I just turned it over and started working on the opposite face. We don't need to know what colour is opposite because we can just look at the centrepiece and we know it's blue. So as with the green, the first step is we need to make a line of 3 going through the middle. So So look for a centerpiece here, an edge piece. See, it's on the top. We want it on this middle row here. So turn it on the middle row, and that's so when we turn it up, it will join this piece here. So now we've got two of our first line. But you see how we've brought a line of green up? We just need to turn this out of the way so we can return a green. So now look for another middle edge piece. I've got one here. It is attached to a corner, but don't worry about that. I can still use that. I can look around and I've got one here that isn't. So I can just move this one up. Now I've got a line of three. Turn it vertically so I can turn my green back down. So once I've completed my first line of three through the middle, I want to start making another line of three on one of these side faces. So the first step is to find a middle piece. I've got one here, it's already attached to one. Bottom right again. I just need one on the top right, so I'll look around. I've got one on the bottom right here. I can turn this to the top right. I can bring it around, and I've made a line of three. Now, stand this one vertical, and I can turn this blue up to meet. But you see, I've pulled this green out. So in order to return this green, if I return this green, I'll split the blue again. So put the blue on the top. Turn it 180 degrees. So now I can return this green. Okay, just need to make one last row of blue. So first look for the middle piece. Here it is. This time it is on the bottom. So either turn it to the middle left or middle right. I'll just go middle left this time. No particular reason. So now we need one on the top left and bottom left. I've got one on the top left here. So bring that one round. And this one is on the bottom left. If it wasn't, we just turn it and put it on the bottom left. And bring it round. Now we've got a final row of blue. Now we need to put it on top. If we turn it on top, you see we bring out a green. If we return a green, we split the blue. So how do we get it up here and keep the green intact? Well, if you look, these pieces are actually the top pieces because these pieces here are opposite the green. So what we can do, move these blue out of the way for the moment. We bring these top pieces down to this face. See, these pieces are opposite the green. So we brought this top layer down. This is on the top. Replace them with blue. Now we can turn them back up, which will also repair our green. Now we've completed two opposing faces. So now just turn your cube. So now we've got one complete face here, one complete face here. Now we're just doing these last four faces. I'm doing it this way, we can work on all four faces with no risk of disturbing these. Some people like to do one, two, three faces in that order. When you're doing the others, you're always splitting another face. I find this way much simpler. So now, pick a colour to start with. Just for consistency, I'm going to choose white. I'm going to break this up as well. I'm going to start with white, so find a white piece. There's no reason to start with white on this time. I'm just doing it for consistency through my videos, per my 4x4. But we don't need to worry about the orientation of colours, as I said, because they're already set. So it's the same rule of thumb, basically. We need to make our first row of three in the middle. So look for a middle piece here. I've got one here. Bring it up. Look for another middle piece. I've got one here. This time it wants to be on the right. Bring it up. And we've got our first row of three. Then we stand that row vertical. Now we can't break it. Next step is to make another row of three. First, find the middle piece. And now the middle piece, we want to stand on this middle layer, the vertical middle layer. So either to this one or this one. So I'll just put it on the top. So now this is on the top. We want a top left and a top right. So look around, we've got a top right here. So I'm going to just bring this up, and that's the first piece. Just need a top left. I've got a top right here. I can just turn that to the top left. Turn it up, and I've got another row of three. Stand it vertical. I can just turn it up and meet the other line. Same again. First, look for the middle piece. I've got one here. It is on the top. So it's on the middle plane. That's where we want it. Or on the bottom would just be fine too. So I want a top left and a top right. I've got a top right here. Pulling that round, we'll pull this one back round, but don't worry, we're not going to break it. Look around. I've got a bottom left. I want a top left. So I'm just going to put this back. In fact, what I can do, I can just move this here, so I can put my white back. Now I know this one's here, and then this one, because this white is on the other white, I can now bring it down and use this empty face. Remember, if I put this back now, this wants to be on the top left, and I can now turn this one. Now it's on a face on its own. I can turn this one to the top left and bring it up. Turn it vertically, and I can turn it up and join them. And that's what we do. It's the same basic principle. You just keep repeating on all the faces. The final two faces can be a bit tricky, but just using the technique and rules that I showed you, you will eventually figure it out. There's so many different connotations on the final two faces, but if you just stick to that basic principle, you will be able to figure it out. For me, working out these centerpieces are the most enjoyable part of doing a 5x5, because you're just thinking and using a bit of logic. You're not following an algorithm that you've memorized. So move to the next face. The next face is the red one. We want to make a horizontal line face. We've got one partly made here, but it's vertical. So I'll just turn it horizontal. Now we just need a middle piece on the right. Got one here. Turn this up. Turn it vertical. We've got our first row of three. Now we want to make another row of three. Again, we choose another face to start making it on. We've got a middle piece here and a middle piece here. Now I've got a bottom right here, and I've got these ones here. So if I turn these in this direction, I just need a bottom right, so I can use this one. I can bring it down and stand it up. And if I turn it up to meet the red, see how I'm breaking my white? What I can do, I can turn it to the other side, and that red wants to go here. Remember, the white is here. I can bring this face down, like we did with the blue, and put the red onto it, and turn it up. Now we just need to make a last row of red, find a middle piece here. Here we have one. Now we've got the corner on the same face, but so we can't use that. We need to bring it down, look where it wants to go. It usually wants to go on the bottom left or bottom right. So I'll turn it to the bottom left. Bring it up, that's one. Now look for the other one. This is on the bottom left, so we need a bottom right. Turn it to the bottom right. Turn it up. Now we've got another row of three. I'm going to turn it to the right, because I know it wants to be on the left. I know we've pulled this one apart, but it's okay if I return it. There it is, but just move them one for now. So it's this one's here. So I know this one wants to go here, because this red's going to come back. It wants to go here. So if I move this down, I can replace them with the red and move them back. And then I can just bring this one back, and the white is still intact. And the final step, these two faces, sometimes they can be really easy, sometimes they can be really tricky. But follow the same rule. The first step is to make a line across the center. Once you've got your line in the center, turn it vertically, then make another line on the bottom, and then push it up, and then make another line. In this case, a lot of them have already turned in the correct position ready, but we still need to make a third line. So we need this on the middle line. I'm going to place it on the bottom, because this is on the bottom. So when I bring it down, It's there, and then I'm going to turn it this way. So I keep this here, and I turn these up, and I put this on the top right. And I can turn this, so it's on the top right. Bring it down, and I've made my last three, like that, and bring it up. Now we've completed this one, automatically we will complete this one, because there's no more left. Now I know you can get stuck on this face, because there is a lot of different connotations you could end up in, and it's a case of just figuring it out, following the rules that I've showed you. Sometimes it will be quite easy like that, other times it will be tricky, but you will be able to figure it out. I'll just mix it up and show you a few more different connotations it could be. For example, I've just mixed them up randomly, in no particular order that I've mixed them up. I just wanted to put a lot of orange up here, so basically starting again on these two faces, just to give you a few more examples. So we want to make the middle row align first. We've already got one in place. I'll use this one. No particular reason, other than that's already a three. So I guess that is a particular reason. I'll bring that up, and that's gave us our three. I'll make it vertical, and I'll bring that down. Now I'm going to move this one up here. I'll move that up there, which means I turn this orange here, and then I've left them up there. So now I need to get these two to match this one. Well, I can already get one matching, because this is top right, and I need one in the top right, so I can get that one matching. But if I move that one back now, it's going to be quite difficult, because we've already got the top right, and this is top right. This can get quite tricky trying to figure this one out. I do admit, I find it difficult to explain what I'm doing. I kind of just work it out, but every time it's in the wrong corner. What you've got to do with this, you've got to kind of replace the three, so I think it's in the wrong order. You see, I'm going to bring this line that's correct. It's kind of opposite, if you know what I mean. I need to swap this one with this one. So I bring it down, I bring a three down, turn it round, and put that three up. So I've sort of switched it. So now these two will be yellow instead of these two. Now these two are yellow, so when I bring this top one down, it meets. You understand what I did there? When it was that way, it's almost like one of these corners is set in the wrong place. Even though it's a correct colour, it's set in the wrong place. See, they're in the wrong place. You can never rotate these right. I can't get this one over here. I need to make sort of an L, because I can't get this one just here on its own, or I'll bring these down, you see. So if you get stuck where it's always in the wrong corner, do this. Bring a full one down, so it's like an L. Turn it down to put a full one back. And you've basically just swapped these. That is the one you tend to get stuck on most, when you just can't figure out to get the corner in the right place. Then we can bring this one down, turn it up, and completed our centers. And there's so many other ways, but you'll figure it out. That's one of the trickiest ones, and you just get stuck with one and you can't get in the correct corner. So the next step is working on these edge pieces. So check out my next video, and we'll start working on these edge pieces.